All right, guys, we're back with the Deaf Great Dane, and let me fix my shot. I've got my pager. I'm just doing this as a recording, and I'm hiding the plant over there. Or hiding the iPad and the plant, because I don't have Wi-Fi out here, so. Anyway. Okay, guys, we're back with Sarah. Oh, she's a wreck at Ralph. So I've got the 280 on her. She does need a new everything low. She's fluid. So even if you're doing indoor training. Oh, hi, George. Oh, look how big she's getting, George. All right, watch. I'm gonna get her up there. And if you don't have velocity to spare, you've got to realize they're not gonna do it. Is if none of your training involves heightened reality, as soon as it's heightened reality, you're out of the scene. Just making it the recall. And you can get one organically backing up. She turns this way too. George wants to see you jump. All right, watch, George. All I've got to do is get my little ribbon. go like this. And she flies through the air with the greatest of ease. Oh, what a cute dog. And she's bringing her down to the pond. So I'm going to be ready to do the recall, get her back. And she's got to deliver to hand. All right, so she goes over there. I can turn her with the page over. You know, I mean, honestly, the basis of technical training is being able to bend the dog back in your direction. I mean, if you said, well, that's the same thing with rivers and harnessing momentum. Yes! I'm telling you, they specifically teach horses to bend, because if they don't bend, you're in trouble. They won't go the way you want them to go. Okay, so she also fetches, and the upside of her, she can pick up big things. Oh, let me show you what I've got. I don't really have anything big today, but these are the things that I have. This is the Christmas episode, George. You said, how is it Christmas? This box. This is representing, hello, Go Ball. Oh, this is the Christmas, whoops. Said it might fall. Okay, hang on. Okay, sorry about that. All right, so we've got, all right, she's got the present. Said, well, what if our present's all wrecked? I know. Don't do it with anything fragile. All right, so let me put it down here. So this is the so-called phone. So what's my plan? Yeah, we don't really recommend you do this with your valuable, fragile items. Hang on. She can't pick it up if it's upside down. Oh, yeah, that's not too good. There's my pager. Your keys to be able to drive to the store to buy another bucket. I think I remember saying that last time. Okay, but she got to get the bucket. You said, what do I do? Make it a much smaller task. Oh, she's precious. Okay, so now she's got to remember that that present's down there, and I just have to look down there to help her. Let her know that's not going to work. Your job is just keep looking at it. She doesn't have very good eyesight, but if you said what, she might smell it. Thank you. precious angel. Just put it right in the thing.
So, but I made that happen by getting it all in motion. If I would have just stood there and said, come here, come here, come here, I'm telling you, it would not have been good. Okay, so. Cutest dog ever. Yeah, you should see. It almost looks brand new. Yeah, I have a thing about buying these all the time. I still do have my old phone that fits this thing, but
she smelled it. She didn't see it drop. I think, you know, you're gonna get in trouble though if you don't have a place. If you haven't done a lot of trained retrieve or delivered a hand and all these things, I will tell you they all use a platform and table, all the services. You're gonna get in trouble fast if you don't use one. If you said how good you're gonna be doing a lot of come here, gimme, gimme, gimme. All right, there's my hand.
I'm just saying, meet me over there. I'm stepping away from the object, if anything. Oh, I hope you saw that, George. She puts it right in my hand.
So. And I did. I used the nick on her when she was jumping up at me. She's a little obnoxious. I mean, you've got to be careful with one of these, and you've seen it. They'll overwhelm another dog. She got out when Millie was out and just started King Konging her and tapped her practically to go back. You know, I got Millie and Luna inside real quick. Got them away from Godzilla.
She was Godzilla-ing them.
Okay, let's go down here. Let me see what's going on with my recording. Anyway, you guys, that's where I'm at. I'm going to go down by the pond, but I will be back later.